Hello and welcome back to Irma Sofra. Today we're going to be making a Balkan classic ćevape. If you've never made them at home, I'm going to show you my way of making them. You're never going to get them at the store again because these are so good. So stay tuned for my recipe. So if you've been following me for a long time, you usually know that in my recipes, there's always like the star of the show. So the star of the show for ćevape are actually surprisingly onions. Because back home, they don't use pricey cuts of meat to make ćevape. They use actually the cheapest quality meat to make them. So they need something for those cheap cuts of meat to give it this crazy amount of flavor. And what that is onions and a little bit of garlic, but onions is really the star of the show. So we need to use a good quality. I'm using a yellow onion. I'm using 4 small yellow onions, or you can use 2 large onions. And we're gonna finely chop this in our electric chopper, and I'm gonna show you what it looks like. We were looking for it to be finely chopped up, almost for like baby food, and we want some of the juice of that onion to also come out. That's the right consistency in order to make really good, really awesome ćevape. Okay, so I have my ground beef here. I have my onions that right over there looks like some mashed potatoes. I'm adding some water to my ground beef, and then I'm gonna add my onion puree. I added like 3 cloves of garlic to this too, and you'll see that is pureed up nice. I mean, just for like baby food when you think about it. And I like that there's a lot of liquid coming out of that because it's gonna give my ground beef a lot of flavor. And for my ćevape, I just do some pepper, I do salt, and I do baking soda for my spices. Baking soda is a key factor to making ćevape. And that's all I do, that's all I add, and I'm adding some breadcrumbs to it. And the breadcrumbs are actually the glue that combines everything together. So it's a very important factor in making ćevape. You can add garlic powder, you can add cayenne pepper, you can add red pepper flakes, you can add whatever you want to your specific ćevape. I don't add a lot of spices because my kid does eat them and he doesn't like it to be too spicy. So all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna mix this until well combined. I use some plastic gloves and then I'm gonna double and triple wrap this because you don't want your fridge to smell like ćevape forever. And then you're gonna let this sit at least 24 hours. And I say at least because the longer it sits in the fridge, the better they'll taste. So I recommend like 30 to 48 hours for them to sit and then for you to shape them. So as I mentioned before, back home they use the cheapest, fattiest cuts of meat to make ćevape. Now, I personally don't like fattier ćevape only because when you use a fattier type of ground beef, they shrivel up in size when you go to bake them. So I use a 90% lean. That's my personal preference for whenever I'm cooking, but you can use a fattier type. Just keep in mind that when you do bake them, they might shrivel up. I also don't add a lot of water to my recipe because of that reason, and they stay a beautiful plump size when you end up baking them. Okay, so the next day, before I start forming the ćevape, I make a little patty, literally it's like the size of a quarter, and what I'm doing is I just fry it up real quick and I want to taste it. Now, I recommend you doing that too because my preferences are maybe different to your preferences. Maybe you like things saltier, maybe you want to add some more spices to it, it's totally up to you. So I do recommend making just a little portion for yourself just to taste it and see if you want to add, you could add maybe more garlic powder, you could add some cayenne, you can add some red pepper flakes, really anything to it and make it your own. But I do recommend doing that because you want to make sure that it tastes good for you and for your family. So I've tried my meat, it came out wonderful, so I'm going to proceed on making the actual ćevape in the traditional shape. I use a bottle of water because I don't have a fancy machine to form these, and all I do is I cut the bottom half and I fill it with the meat and then I press. Now the first one I made too small, and then the second one you guys will see it actually comes out the perfect size. I ended up using my pointer finger as a guide, so the size of my pointer finger was the perfect size for these ćevape, and what's great about my recipe is I don't use a lot of water in my recipe, so they actually don't shrivel up when you're making them. If you guys have made them at home, you'll notice sometimes or on the grill that they shrivel up and they get really small, and that's because the people that are making them, they add a little too much water. but these actually stay the size that you make them, which is great. Now, once I've used up all of my meat, I just kind of go and make sure that all of them kind of look unified and nice. If they're crooked, I kind of try to straighten them out. And then if there's any little holes because we were piping them out, I kind of just fill that in. And then what I do is I take the piece of parchment paper and I actually cut it down the width. And then I'm going to take two pieces of foil and I'm going to then wrap them in the foil. And these are actually great because you can put them in the freezer and they're awesome for up to 6 months. Finally, it is time to cook up our chivapas. So what I did is I used a nonstick griddle and a little bit of oil because as I mentioned before, I'm using a leaner cut of meat and I just make sure that all the sides of the chivap are beautiful and golden brown. I cook these on a medium low setting just because I don't want to cook the outside really fast and then have the inside be raw. And that's pretty much it. Serve this with some onions and a lot of bread and you have homemade chivapa. Perfect. I absolutely love this recipe and I know you guys will too. Thank you so much for watching. Please be sure to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and add me on Instagram. I'll see you guys next time.